Hello everybody, my name is Walter and today I want to show you how I can build my redesigned and much more compact 10x10 double door you can see right in front of you. As you can see, it looks like a simple 10x10 tunnel with a bit of decoration in the walls and a button on this side and also on the opposite side. And if I were to press that, the whole thing will start closing up within just a few seconds and I have this nicely looking and also lit up wood door design. And of course it looks the same from the back side too. And if I were to press any of those buttons, the whole thing will start opening up again within just a few seconds. And I'm back to the flat tunnel. So that's basically what the thing it does. As I already mentioned, this is a redesign of my previous version, which was from before observers got introduced. And now with observers, I was able to compact it down quite a bit. And with that said, let's get talking about the sizes. So it is in total 11 blocks long. This also includes the front and back wall. It has a total width of 24 blocks and a total height of 22 blocks. So quite compact, actually. Pretty much the compactest you can build this entire thing in the current Minecraft. So anyway, let's talk about the required resources. By the way, the visible glowstone blocks here are just to light up the entire thing. They are not really necessary for the thing here to work, but they keep mobs from spawning inside of there. Anyway, let's get to resources. So you're gonna need, of course, building blocks and quite a bit more than just one stack. Then 19 slabs, a total of 206 slime blocks, a total of 180 obsidian blocks, then 307 redstone dust, 59 redstone torches, 93 redstone repeaters, 35 comparators, 2 redstone blocks, a total of 83 observers, sorry, and 155 sticky pistons, 83 normal pistons, then 24 hoppers, 8 levers, 2 buttons as inputs, maybe some additional redstone dust if you want to relocate the buttons. Then finally you're gonna need a total of 136 eggs, or another item with a stack size of 16, which is in total 8 stacks and a half. And that's basically all you're gonna need, so let's quickly show you how to build this door here.
Okay, so the first step is marking the center of the door with 2 immovable blocks at the floor level. Then from the right one of those, you go down 4 blocks and place an observer right there. Then put a slime block next to it. And next to that we need first 2 sticky pistons, then observers, then again sticky pistons. Then grab 2 more observers, place them diagonally to the sticky pistons there. Then we need again diagonally, this time 3 sticky pistons diagonally to the slime block here. Then with a 1 wide gap, another 2 sticky pistons front and back. Next, grab some slime blocks, place 4 in an L shape here, 3 there, and another L shape on this side. Then we need on top of those corners here sticky pistons. Next, grab some obsidian blocks and place them in there. Then let's quickly grab 2 more observers, place them here, and in those corners some more sticky pistons. Then next, grab a few normal blocks, place them right there. Then we need a raised block here and there, followed by 5 blocks as you can see here, then another row of 5 blocks right here, followed by an up and down of another 5 blocks as you can see here. Then place 1 comparator right in this gap, and the rest are repeaters, 1 tick, 1 tick, 2 ticks and 1 tick. Then we need a lever on this block and on this block here, followed by redstone dust in those three gaps here. One redstone dust in there, and three redstone dusts here, with two obsidian blocks cutting off the wire in those directions. Then put redstone dust on top of those five blocks here. Next we need a raised block, lowered block, raised block, and so on. One layer above that, with comparators going outwards, as you can see here. Put some redstone dust on top of this block. Then place three blocks like that, with comparators on top of them, with this one here in the subtract mode, then two blocks behind here, with two hoppers facing each other next to them. Then full block here and there, torches on the side of both. Then we need another block here, again with a torch, this time below that block here. Then place a row of nine blocks, like so, raised block, and then another six blocks in a row, as you can see here, followed by a line of blocks until you are in line with this observer there. Then block here, two blocks here, and one more block there, followed by a repeat on one tick there, and then on those blocks here, place redstone dust. Here you place redstone dust, except for the last two, where you place two repeaters on four ticks each. Then observer on top of the redstone dust and this repeater there, with a block right here. Then a block in there. Then next we go up a bit. Then on top of the redstone wire, then down again. Then around the corner like so. Next place a sticky piston down there with a full block here. Put redstone dust on top of those blocks. And on top of this hopper here. Then, quickly before we actually fill in the hoppers, place one immovable block here, so this will not get confused. Because now it's time to place in 14 eggs inside of this hopper here. And if we hadn't blocked this here from moving, this could have gone wrong. Anyway, the transfer should stop when 8 eggs are in this and 6 eggs are in this hopper here. Then let's quickly move this block here one layer down. Then on this side here, we need first 4 redstone dust, then 2 repeaters on 4 ticks each again, followed by 2 observers, as you can see here. Then place 2 more observers looking at this piece of redstone dust right there, followed by saline blocks, and then 2 sticky pistons on the sides of each saline block, as you can see there. Then diagonally we need 2 more sticky pistons, as you can see here. Top that off with saline blocks. Then in here we need 2 obsidian blocks, then 3 normal blocks, another normal block in there, and raised normal block here around the corner. Then redstone dust on top of those 2 blocks and those 2 blocks here. Then repeaters on one tick each in this direction. A block in this gap here with redstone dust on top. Then cut off the wire with normal blocks. A torch on the top of this block and on the side of this block here. Next, place 2 blocks like so. Put down 2 comparators, this one here in the subtract mode. Then we need 2 more blocks here with comparators, as you can see there. Then raised blocks behind them, with 2 hoppers facing each other behind that. Then we need a normal block in there, and 2 more raised here. Put down redstone dust there, and 1 final piece there. Then place down 2 blocks like this here. Grab 2 torches, place them like that, and a redstone dust on top of this block here. Then let's place 1 block on top of this observer there, followed by 2 more blocks here, then 1 layer above 1 normal block, followed by an upside down slab and 2 more normal blocks, another normal block to cut off a future wire here, 1 block on top of the comparator there, then put redstone dust on top of those blocks here, grab a sticky piston, place it facing downwards here, and a normal block right below that. Then you can once more place 14x inside of this hopper here, and the transfer should stop at 6x transferred. Then let's go to this torch here, place the block on top, and then we need a sticky piston to the side of it, with an observer to the face, running into a full block, with a lowered full block, with some redstone dust in there. Then next to the redstone dust we need two obsidian blocks, followed by normal blocks as you can see here, with repeaters on 2 tick each, like that. Then diagonally to the normal blocks, we need some obsidian blocks with redstone dust on top, as you can see here. Now let's return to the left side here. First place a block on top of this torch with a sticky piston to the side of it, an observer in this direction, then a block here, then a block on top of this torch with another raised block here. Grab an upside down snap, place it here, then another raised block there. Put down 2 redstone dust and repeat on 2 ticks here. Torch on the side of this block, then diagonally to the torch we need a block here, which is the first block of a row of 7 blocks. Then lowered block and raised block here. The same on this side. In those gaps we need repeaters on 1 tick each. Then redstone dust on top of those blocks here. Then from this block here go down 1 block and another block. Then 2 blocks up, 2 blocks down, 2 blocks up, down and up. Put redstone dust on top of those blocks we just placed. The same we need on this side here. So 2 down, then 2 up, 2 down, 2 up, and down, up. Redstone dust. And then on the top blocks we need torches facing inwards, as you can see here. Now let's go to the back side. First place 1 block next to this redstone wire there, then 2 lowered blocks, then towards the right side it's another 3 blocks in this row and 6 blocks on the left side. Then raise 2 blocks here and a 3rd one there. The same on this side here. Put down redstone dust on top of those blocks. And on this block and this block I repeat on 1 tick each. Those are, by the way, the connection points to the side components later on. Then we need a block next to this redstone wire there. Then a lowered and raised block. In this gap we need a repeat on 1 tick. Then diagonally to this block here we need a sticky piston. Then with a 1 wide gap next to the repeater we need another sticky piston with a normal block in between those two. Then diagonally we need 2 blocks here with torches, as you can see here. Then let's grab 2 blocks, place them down like that with torches. Let's start on this side, then on this side. Now we can place another block lowered down here with some redstone dust on top, which would then power this repeater and thus the entire thing. Then we need 2 hoppers facing each other in this corner. Then we take outputs with comparators in this direction, running into full blocks. Then we have again going on an up and down of 3 blocks on each side. Redstone dust in those corners and repeaters on 1 tick each in those corners and on top of the hoppers. Then we need a row of blocks from front to back. As you can see here, put redstone dust on top of those. Those are is actually our input line, so we can for now place our buttons right there. Then we need finally 2 torches on the side of those blocks, powering those repeaters here. And the last part is filling in 14 items inside of those hoppers here, which spam proofs the entire thing. Now grab some obsidian blocks, place them first diagonally to this sticky piston, this one here and this one here, then quickly mirror this to the front part. Then we need another obsidian block next to this sticky piston in front of the redstone wire there. Then the following parts can be mirrored from front to back, so start with an L shape of 4 slime blocks at the center with normal pistons at this level. Then we need a 2x2 of slime blocks on top of this sticky piston there with normal block pistons to the front. Then two more slime blocks and a normal piston right there. Then again two slime blocks on top with a 1-height gap and another one to this side here. Place down two normal pistons here. Then we need three slime blocks here and again with a 1-height gap two there. Then make this into an L shape there. Finally place three normal pistons there and sticky pistons on top of all these torches here. Then we can place normal blocks on top of all slime blocks and pistons. Then obsidian blocks on those points here. And now we can give it a try. So let's simply power the button here. And now everything should extend as you can see here. And if we press the button once more, the whole thing should also retract and flatten out properly, which means now it's time to properly mirror this. And after that, let's quickly fill in another three obsidian blocks here on top of the slime blocks and down there. And then the rest can be filled in with normal blocks without any issue. And after you've done that, it's finally time to start building in the two sides. So now the sides are built pretty much the same, just mirrored. So I will show you how to build the right side and then mirror it during the cuts. So let's start. Our reference point is this redstone dust here, or this redstone dust on the left side there. Then we need a block next to that, followed by another two blocks here. Then one little difference between the sides. On this side here, due to the torch below that, we need a upside down step here. On the opposite side, this can be a normal block. And also only needed on this side here is a block here to cut off a future wire. Then place a torch on top of this block. Two repeaters on three ticks each here. Two more repeaters on four ticks each there. Redstone wire there. Then in this corner, we need a normal block. Next to the torch, we need another normal block with another torch to this side, an obsidian block on top, torch on the side of that. Then place down two hoppers facing each other, as you can see here. Then a full obsidian block here, full block there. Then let's go down one layer, place down two comparators in this direction, another block with a comparator in this direction, this one here in the subtract mode. Then we need a sticky piston here with a full block to the face of it, as you can see there. Then place a observer on top of this torch with a full block to this on top and on the side here, with a repeat on four ticks in this direction with a block to the face and a torch right here. Now the sticky piston should extend. Next, let's place another two blocks going up, then one block in the same height, then up and down around the corner. Then an upside down step, three normal blocks, upside down step, two normal blocks, one more block around the corner. Then two blocks going down and one up. Put down redstone dust on top of those blocks. A repeater on one tick on this block and three more redstone dust there. Then, while we're here, let's actually place another block in here with a lever there and another lever on this side. Then let's go and first place a block to the face of this comparator there. Then we go up with two blocks to this side and to this side here. And inwards with another two blocks, put down forwards and dust and a repeater on four ticks here. Repeaters on one tick each there. Then a full block to the face of the repeater here with a sticky piston to the side. On top of it then observer to the face, block on top and some redstone dust on top of that. Then here we need another raised block and a lowered block here with some redstone dust there, which should be redirected through those levers here, the same on this side of course. Like this here. Next, grab a normal block, place it right next to the hopper here, put some redstone dust on top and power it with a torch on the side of this block. Then you can place in 20x inside of this hopper here. The transfer should stop when 6x have been transferred. Then while we're down here, let's place two blocks up there, some redstone dust on top of this one, then two more normal blocks here, and then two obsidian blocks going up in diagonally, on each side of course, with redstone dust on top of those blocks here. Then let's go to the outside here first. At the head of the observer we need a normal sticky piston, and then behind that diagonally we need two normal pistons with an obsidian block right there. Then at the back here, starting down there with three sticky pistons and an observer, and build a little tower. Then in front of that a column of four slime blocks and three sticky pistons next and on top of the top slime block there, which we quickly can mirror to this side. Then let's place a obsidian block diagonally to those two sticky pistons there. Of course this is on the opposite side too. Then we need two slime blocks here. Then three more slime blocks in an L shape like so. And another three slime blocks straight out here. Then let's quickly go and fill in a sticky normal piston here and two more normal pistons there. Followed by blocks to the face of the slime blocks and pistons, at which time we can give it a try. So let's press the button here and let's see if this part is working properly, which it does, except for the leveling out, which comes later on, which means that we can now mirror this to the front half. Now is a good time to start filling in a bit of the wall, so start right here with a obsidian block, then we need another three obsidian blocks going down next to that, then an obsidian block here and in this gap, and then we more or less mirror this simply. So, then the rest of this wall here can, up to this level here, be filled in with normal blocks. Like this here. Next, let's go to the outside here. First, place three blocks on the redstone dust down there. Then we need two upside down slabs, as you can see here. Put redstone dust on top of all these. Then an observer in this gap in the center. Normal blocks to this side and then forward two obsidian blocks. Put down a repeater on two and four ticks. Four and two ticks, as you can see here. Then we need a block on top of this redstone wire with some redstone dust on top, followed by a block up there with a torch to this side, which should now power this contraption there. Then we need a repeater in this direction on four ticks. Although first let's actually place a observer there, then the repeater on four ticks, followed by a block right there. Then we need an observer on top of this redstone wire there, followed by three sticky pistons, as you can see here. Then another four sticky pistons on top of the observer, followed by five saline blocks, as you can see here. Then grab some saline blocks and place them in an L shape like so, followed by three saline blocks on each side here. Put down two normal pistons to front and back. Then we need two more normal pistons there. Put behind both of those some immovable blocks like that. Then we can again start filling in this segment of the wall. And don't forget the obsidian in there. After that, let's go to this front corner here. Place a block in there with some redstone dust on top. Then go up with two more normal blocks. Place an observer facing downwards right there. Put down two redstone dust, as you can see there. Then two sticky pistons, two normal pistons, and then another two sticky pistons there. And here we need a double piston extender, as you can see, like so. Grab two saline blocks, place them like this here. Then we can again start filling in this part of the wall. Next, let's go and place an observer looking at this stick piston, like so. Then run this output into a repeater on vortex with a block to the face. Then we need a sticky piston here facing downwards with an observer facing in this direction. Next, place a hopper on top of this line block here. An observer looking at the hopper, then another observer looking at this piston there. Another two going around in a kind of U-shape, as you can see there. Put down one redstone dust on top of the hopper. Then we need blocks on top and to the side of the redstone dust. A repeater here on one tick, then behind that an obsidian block, then up and down another two with redstone dust on top of those. Then let's go to the back corner here. First, again, block with redstone dust here. Then two blocks going up and the observer here. One redstone dust there. But this time we need actually a lever on the top of this block here. Then hovering above that we need another observer with redstone dust on top. As you can see here, on top of that another normal block. Then let's go and place the two obsidian block and sticky pistons here, two normal pistons, then the double piston extender, and again two normal sticky pistons there. Then don't forget the two saline blocks. Now we can again start filling in this part of the wall. Then we need once more our hopper, the observer looking at it, then the U-shape of three observers right here. Let's send us on top of the observer, hopper here, then the two blocks, a repeater here, then an observer looking at the repeater with a obsidian block on top, block to the side with a repeater on three ticks this time, running into a sticky piston with an observer facing downwards like so. And at this point it would be a good idea to give it a try, so simply power this central line there. Now those here should extend. And if I unpower it, it should retract and also flatten out those segments here. Next, let's quickly place in two observers I forgot earlier. So for that, remove this normal piston here and place an observer there, the same on this side. Then replace them. And if I now were to try it out, this segment here should also flatten out properly, as you can see there. Then let's actually start filling in the rest of the wall here. And we need to go all the way up, since those line blocks will touch the wall. Then when we have done that, we can actually fill in the rest with normal blocks, like this here. Next, let's go to the back corner again. First place some redstone dust on top of this block, cut off the wire with a normal block, and then on top of that a sticky piston with three slime blocks. Top off with a redstone block. Next, place an obsidian block here, followed by two normal blocks. Put down repeaters on four and three ticks, running into a full block with a torch on top. Then next to this we need a block with some redstone dust, like so. Then a block here with a torch on the side of it, block on top and torch on the opposite side. Then another block up here, redstone, a normal block on top of the torch there, redstone repeater here, running into a full block with a redstone dust here. Then for the moment, let's shortly remove this redstone dust here. Now place a torch there, then replace the torch dust again. Then let's go and grab two hoppers, place them facing each other, as you can see here. Put down an obsidian block right here, followed by two normal blocks, as you can see there. Grab three comparators, place them like so. This one here, the subtract mode. Then we need two observers looking at this free space here and the repeater there. Put down a full block there and redstone dust here. Next we need a sticky piston next to the redstone dot with a full block below it. Then let's go and place a full block there, torch on top of that, followed by a block on top of that, another two blocks here, followed by an upside down slab on top of the hopper here, followed by a normal block. Then let's place a block up there and finally place down four redstone dust, as you can see here. Then inside of this hopper here, let's place 20x. The transfer once more, or in this time, should stop at 9x transferred. Then let's go and place one block there. Then diagonally we go down with three obsidian blocks. Put down redstone dust on top of those. Then on the side of this obsidian block we need a torch with a temporary block here, so we can now place a sticky piston facing downwards, which should now connect to this observer right there. Then let's quickly grab a hopper, place it on top of this redstone wire here. Then place a block right here, another block right there, and then on top of the hopper some redstone dust. Next we need to first place a kind of circle of normal blocks, then raise those two blocks here, put down a repeater on one tick here, then two on four ticks each there, and then connect another two redstone wire to this part there. And that should actually be all, so let's give it a try, simply by pressing the button, and then let's see if this works properly. That's looking good, and now let's see if it also opens properly. And that's what we want to see. So now it's time to start with the top part. So now for the top part, let's start on the right side once more with an obsidian block next to the redstone block there. Then go up with four normal blocks diagonally like this here. Put redstone dust on top of those blocks here. Then an upside down slab here, again with redstone dust on top. Then we need two blocks here with a repeat on one and four ticks, running into a full block with a torch on top, block on top and two to the side here. Two repeaters on four ticks each, running into a full block with a torch to the side there. Put down two hoppers facing each other like this here, then two blocks besides this. Then we need three blocks down there, with a comparator and subtract mode here and two there. Then place an observer on top of the redstone dust, with a block to the side on top. Repeat on four ticks in there, running into a full block with a torch to the side of it, which powers a sticky piston right there, with a full block right in this corner there. Then place a block in front of the comparator there, with a torch to the side of that. Put down a full block right below this hopper there, then two blocks there, and a raised obsidian block here, followed by 3 redstone dust there. Then you can place in 14x inside of this hopper here. The transfer should stop at 6x again. Then let's go and place another 2 blocks here. Make this a little platform. Actually, make sure those are obsidian blocks. Put down 2 redstone dust and 2 repeat dust on 2 ticks each on each side. Then let's go to this torch here, place an upside down snap right there, followed by a normal block, and then 3 upside down snaps, followed by 3 more normal blocks. Put redstone dust on top of those blocks, then grab 3 normal pistons, place one in this direction, one here, and the last one there. Next, let's go to the left side. Again, we start with an obsidian block next to the redstone block, then we go up with 3 blocks in diagonal. Next, place an upside down snap next to this block there, then another block there, and on top of the redstone wire. Then let's put redstone dust on top of these blocks here. Next, we need 2 blocks here, with a repeat on 1 and on 4 ticks, running into a full block with a torch on top. Block on top, 2 blocks to the side, 2 repeaters on 4 ticks each, like that. Running into a full block, with a torch to the side of it. Then next to that we need 2 hoppers facing each other, as you can see here. Then next to that, 2 normal blocks, then 3 blocks down here, with a comparator on the subtract mode and 2 more. Then let's place an observer on top of this redstone wire in the corner here. Block on top and to the side. Repeat on 4 ticks taking an output, running into a full block, torch to the side of it, then a sticky piston next to that with a full block now in this corner here. Then in front of the comparator here we need a full block, then up and down to front and back. Then 3 lower blocks as you can see here, and then we essentially copy this up and down pattern once more. As you can see here, then 3 normal blocks, 2 obsidian blocks in the corners, then 2 more obsidian blocks, and then we go down with another obsidian block, like this here. Then let's grab first 3 comparators going out from this block, then 2 more there, then redstone dust on top of these blocks, and the obsidian blocks back there, and repeaters on 1 tick on those blocks here. And then let's quickly place a torch on the side of this block, then a block below this hopper there. Then we need diagonal of that, another 2 blocks and some redstone dust there. Then a block here to cut off that wire. And finally let's place in 14x inside of this hopper here. The transfer should stop at 6x transferred. So next up, let's go down here. The first thing is we can actually remove those blocks here. This was one layer too high actually. The same on this side. Then on the left side you can also replace this obsidian block here with a normal block. Then another normal block down there. Then we go one layer lower. Place an obsidian block here, followed by a normal block. Then here we make a total of 4 normal blocks. Then raised normal block, lowered obsidian block and normal block. Put redstone dust on top of those blocks here and those blocks at the corners. Then we need a repeater on 2 ticks here and on 2 ticks there. On top of this redstone wire we need 2 observers with a full block on top. The same on this side here. Then going from that we need an obsidian block, then we go down with a normal block, then obsidian block, then we go up again with an obsidian block, a normal block, and then 2 normal blocks and down and 1 obsidian block. And then put redstone dust on top of those blocks. And we need the same on this side here, so obsidian block, then lowered normal block, obsidian block, raised obsidian block, normal block, lowered normal blocks, and raised obsidian block, again redstone dust on top of them, like this here. Then on the right side, we need a torch here, with a sticky piston on top. Then an observer to the face of that, running into a full block. Below that, a full block with some redstone dust on top. Then, next to that, we go up with three obsidian blocks, like so. The same on this side. And then we put down redstone dust on top of those blocks, like that. Next, let's go to this point here. First, let's remove this block here and replace it with an obsidian block with the repeater on top, since slime blocks will be moving next to that. After that, let's grab some observers. First, place one here, here, and there. Finally, another two here and there. Then go below here and place three sticky pistons, like this. Then another two right here and here. So you get this configuration here. Then grab some slime blocks, place four in an L shape here. Then we need four here in a straight line and then another L shape here. Place a observer there and here. Another observer in there. Then grab some sticky pistons, place them in this corner and this corner here. The same on this side and there. Then in here, as you can see there. Then let's go to this side here. Again, we start with some sticky pistons in front of the repeaters. Followed by three slime blocks. And then two more sticky pistons like so. And the same on this side mirrored. Like this here. Then let's once more go down here and first place a sticky piston there and here. And from here on the following steps can be mirrored from front to back, so I will show you just one half of that. So for that, let's start at the very center here with an L shape of four slime blocks with two normal pistons at this level there. Then on the left side we need a 2x2 of slime blocks with again two normal pistons. Then with a one high gap, we need two slime blocks here. So a one high gap between the slime blocks and the sticky piston. Again with a normal piston there, then here two sticky pistons, two normal pistons, not two sticky pistons and a normal piston. Then here we need again two slime blocks and then a third one to this side. Then here we need three slime blocks and then a fourth one to this side. Again with two normal pistons up there. Then with a one high gap, once more, two slime blocks, and that's pretty much the entire thing. So let's quickly put blocks below all slime blocks and pistons. And then let's give it a try. And as you can see now, this half is working properly, which means that now it would be time to actually mirror this. Then let's quickly go and place in some obsidian blocks at the center here, then going along the edge of this part here. And on the left side, we need below those slime blocks also obsidian blocks, and then the rest can be filled in with normal blocks. And it should end up looking similar to this here. Just one little note here, I had to place two more obsidian blocks here, diagonally going from those lines here, so it's at least partially symmetrical except for the center part here. If you don't place them there, then the whole thing here will not work properly. But besides of that, let's give it final test run, so simply press the button and see if everything works. So that's looking good so far. Now the opening And with that also working, it's now finally time to fill in the front and back wall, the missing floor, then relocate the button to somewhere where you can actually reach it, and maybe light up the enterhousing to keep mobs from spawning. And voila! So, anyway, that was how you can build my redesigned and compact 10x10 double door. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial, and well, see ya!